हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर सुशांत मोहिते, वर्किंग एज अ हेड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। आई एम सब्जेक्ट इन चार्ज ऑफ एनर्जी कंजर्वेशन एंड ऑडिट। नेक्स्ट, टीचिंग स्कीम ऑफ फिफ्थ सेमिस्टर। देन द कोर्स आउटकम्स and teaching and examination scheme of our subject, that is energy conservation and audit. We already discussed about course outcomes and teaching and examination scheme in our first video, that is in unit number 1. Now we start the unit number 3, that is energy conservation in electrical installation system. This is the course outcomes of topic number or unit number 3, that is COC, apply energy conservation techniques in electrical installation. Then learning outcomes, interpret losses in the given power system. The next, explain the method to reduce the specified technical loss in the given electrical installation. Next, explain the method to reduce the specified commercial loss in the given electrical installation. Next, select the relevant energy conservation equipment for the given system with justification. Next, explain energy conservation measures for the specified lighting installation. Next, energy conservation techniques in transmission and distribution system. In unit number 3, there are two parts. The first part 1 is the energy conservation technique in transmission and distribution system, and the second one, the energy conservation technique in electrical installation, means it's a residential system. Next, the introduction. The introduction part of the unit number 3. In the beginning of 19th century, the use of electrical power was limited. Due to little demand, small power stations were built to supply simple lighting and heater load. And these power stations were built near the load. So transmission of electricity was restricted to small distances. Later on, in the beginning of 20th century, widespread of electrical power necessitated to produce bulk electrical power. The big power station were located at suitable site. For example, hydropower plant is located where ample storage of water is available. Thermal power plant is located where sufficient supply of coal along with transport facility is available. Thus, the necessity of long transmission line arises because now the big power stations may not be near the load. The electricity from generating stations is to be brought to the consumers through conductors, and the systems through which it is brought is called transmission and distribution system. This is the introduction part of our part 1, that is energy conservation technique in transmission and distribution system. Next, the single line diagram of AC power supply scheme. We already studied single line diagram in 4 semester in the subject of EPT, that is electrical power transmission system. The electrical power produced in generating station is transmitted over large distance through transmission lines. Then it is distributed to various consumers through a distribution network. Various storage are involved in between, in which this power is processed and sent further. A typical single line diagram of AC power scheme is shown in this slide. The standard transmission voltages are 132 kV, 220 kV, 400 kV, etc. This diagram gives a general idea about supply system. The next is the various stages and standard voltage levels. The first, generating station. The power is generated at generating stations at 11 kV voltage level. It may be 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV, 11 kV or 33 kV in some cases. It is step up to 110 kV, 132 kV or 220 kV or 400 kV for primary transmission purpose. Three-phase step-up transformer is used to step up the voltage. The advantages of transmitting power at high voltage are reduction in size of conductor, better performance of transmission process. The highest transmission voltage in India is 400 kV. Then classification of transmission. The first one, primary transmission, and the second one, secondary transmission. The first, primary transmission. Power at high voltage, that is 132 kV or 220 kV or 400 kV, is transmitted by means of primary transmission line. It is three-phase, three-wire system, that is overhead tower lines. The second one is a secondary transmission. At receiving station, the voltage is stepped down from 132 kV to 33 kV or 66 kV by means of step-down transformer. From receiving station, electric power is transmitted to substation located at particular points in the city. The overhead three-phase, three-wire system, that is tower line or iron pole, is used for this. The next is a primary distribution. The secondary transmission line terminates at receiving station where the voltage is stepped down to 11 kV or 6.6 kV or 3.3 kV by step-down transformer. And these 11 kV lines run along roadside of city or steel poles. The next is a secondary distribution. The distribution substations are located at consumer premises where voltages of 11 kV is stepped down to 4.5 kV three-phase. It's not a 4.5, it's a 415 volt or 230 volt. That is three-phase, four-wire or single-phase, two wires for secondary distribution. The advantages of using three-phase, four-wire system R, Y, B, neutral, that is red, yellow, black, neutral, are that both three-phase and single-phase supply can be used depending upon the load. Service lines are taken off from these lines. This is the total overview of single line diagram of AC power supply scheme. The next scenario of transmission and distribution losses. The primary, the power plant typically produce 50 hertz alternating current electricity with voltage between 11 kV and 33 kV. At power plant side, the three phase voltage is step up to higher voltage for transmission through conductors strung on towers. High voltage and extra high voltage transmission is the next stage from the power plant to transfer AC power over long distance at voltages like 220 kV and 400 kV. Sometimes for transmission of long distances, say above 100 km, high voltage direct current transmission is used, which minimize the losses. Sub-transmission network at 132 kV, 110 kV, 66 kV or 33 kV constitutes the next link towards the end user. Distribution at 11 kV, 6.6 kV or 3.3 kV constitutes the last link to consumer who is connected directly or through transformer depending upon demand level of service. The transmission and distribution network include substation or lines and distribution transformer. High voltage transmission is used so that smaller and more economical wires size can be used to carry the lower current and to reduce the losses. Substations containing step down transformer reduce the voltage for distribution to industrial users. The voltage is further reduced for commercial facilities. There is no difference between a transmission and distribution line except for the voltage level and power handling capacity. Transmission lines are usually capable of transmitting large quantities of electricity over large distances. They operate at high voltages. Distribution lines carry limited quantities of power over shorter distances. Voltage drop in the line are in relation to the resistance and reactance of line, length and the current drawn. For the same quantity of power handle, lower the voltage, higher the current drawn and the higher the voltage drop. The current drawn is inversely proportional to the voltage level for the same quantity of power handle. The power loss in the line is proportional to resistance and square of current. Higher voltage transmission and distribution helps to minimize the line voltage drop in the ratio of voltages and the line power loss in the ratio of square of voltages. For example, if the voltage is raised from 11 kV to 33 kV, the voltage drop will be lower by factor 1/3 and the line loss will be lower by 1/3 square, that is 1/9. Lower voltage transmission and distribution also need bigger size conductor on account of current handling capacity needed. Then, the primary function of transmission and distribution equipment is to transfer power economically and reliably from one location to another. Conductor in the form of wires and cable strung on towers and pole carry the high voltage AC current. A large number of copper or aluminium conductor are used to form the transmission path. The resistance of the long distance transmission conductor is to be minimized. Energy loss in transmission line is wasted in the form of I square R loss, that is copper loss. Capacitors are used to correct power factor by causing the current to lead the voltage. When AC currents are kept with voltage, operating efficiency of the system is maintained at a high level. Circuit interrupting devices like switches, relays, circuit breakers and fuses. Each of these devices is designed to carry and interrupt certain level of current. Making and breaking of the current carrying conductors in the transmission path with a minimum arcing in one of the most important characteristics of these devices. Relays sense abnormal voltages, currents and frequency and operate to them protect the system. Transformers are placed at strategic location throughout the system to minimize power losses in the transmission and distribution system. They are used to change the voltage level from low to high or from high to low. The power source to end user energy efficiency link is a key factor which influences the energy input at the source of supply. If we consider electricity flow from generation to the user in terms of cascade energy, a typical cascade efficiency profile from generation to 11 to 33 kV users industry will be as follows. This figure shows the efficiency profile from generation to 11 to 33 kV users industry. The first block In the first block, the generating efficiency, the efficiency range 28 to 35% with respect to size of thermal plant, age of plant and capacity utilization. The next step up station, the step up to 400 or 800 kV to enable EHV, extra high voltage transmission, maximum losses 0.5% or efficiency 99.5%. The next EHV transmission and station, EHV transmission and substation at 400 kV or 800 kV, maximum losses 1% or efficiency 99%. Then next HV, high voltage transmission and station, high voltage transmission and substation for 220 or 400 kV, maximum losses 2.5% or efficiency 97.5%. The next is a substransmission. Substransmission at 66 or 132 kV, maximum losses 4% or efficiency 96%. Step down to a level of 11 or 33 kV, maximum losses 0.5% or efficiency 99.5%. The next distribution station, the next primary distribution. In this, in both block, the distribution is final link to end user at 11 to 33 kV, maximum losses 5% or efficiency 95%. The next is the end user premises, means the efficiency from generation to end user is equal to efficiency 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then multiplication of efficiency 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 into 6 into 7. Means the cascade efficiency in the transmission and distribution system from output of power plant to end user is 87%. We expect 100%, but actually the efficiency from generation to end user premises is a 87%. Means 13% is the losses. Okay, and that's why we study transmission and distribution losses, or the scenario of transmission and distribution losses. When we overcome or when we reduce this losses, this 13% losses, then definitely we conserve the energy at the time of transmission and distribution.